What's up, everybody? Welcome to Alice and Anna. My name is Alice, and today we're going to be reacting to some music. Let's go! One of the best people in the world, and one of the best artists of our time, and just overall in music, Miley Cyrus. I love that woman so freaking much. I know she's like really popular and an icon already and whatever, but I think she's really underrated, I'm not gonna lie. Her voice is truly iconic and unmatched, and I don't know. I really loved her previous era with Plastic Hearts. That was insane, and that was so freaking good. Like that little rocky vibe, like, oh, she's just so good. Her voice is extraordinary, so I'm super excited to be listening to this. It's called Endless Summer Vacation, which is kind of fitting given that it's March and summer is approaching, but whatever. I don't know, I'm super excited. I feel like she tries something different every single time, and she's a very multi-genre artist in my perception. It seems to me like it's gonna be pretty popish, which is like, okay. I did wish it was still in this like weird rock-ish thing, but it's fine. Let's ignore that for now. But yeah, let's check it out. I'm so excited. So for those of you who still haven't listened to Flowers, even though I feel like it's impossible at this point because it's been everywhere, the song is very much like connected to Liam Hemsworth, and people enjoyed the amount of drama in that song. We were good. We were gone. It's this like very kind traditional pop in my view. Started to cry, but then remembered I can buy myself flowers, talk to myself for hours. This is right there. This is the only reason I probably like the song, just because it's a little bit too popish for me and the lyrics are a little bit too cheesy, and I know it's like meant to be and whatever, but still, I wouldn't normally listen to something like this. But because of her voice and because of how beautiful it is, it sends chills down my spine every single time I hear it. I can take myself dancing. The little rasp in her voice, everything, oh my god. Just too good, too good. Song number two is called Jaded, and it has E. It says that it's explicit. I find it very curious because, I mean, it's Miley Cyrus. I would kind of expect the letter E to appear in front of every song, but okay, whatever. We vibe. Ooh, this definitely feels like a summer breeze. I don't wanna go and talk too long. No, it was wrong, but never said I was sorry. Ooh. Her voice! This song is definitely fitting for like summer drives. Can you just envision yourself like sitting in the car with the windows rolled down and there's the summer warm breeze blowing in your face and through your hair, and you're just screaming the song at the top of your lungs, and then there's this like, it's not even sunset yet, it's just golden hour, and you're like by the beach and you can smell the sea, salted ocean air. I just see it all. I feel alive. Oh my god. Don't know when to stop till you take it too far. I know who you are, and I'm left in the dark till I'm worried. It hurts me. We went to hell, but we never came back. I'm sorry that you're jaded. I hate it. Sorry that you're jaded. Oof. The production is really good. It's very, before with Flowers, I wasn't sure because you can never judge the album by the single, so I wasn't sure how poppy it's gonna be. Now I know it's gonna be hella poppy, because even the production of this music is so, like, her voice sounds very pop edited. I don't know. In my personal opinion, she doesn't have a pop voice. She's more suitable for, like, rock, or maybe like for pop, but like harsher songs, and it should be edited accordingly. So even though I appreciate the effort of producing it in a pop manner, I feel it's kind of like adding this really weird texture on top of her voice, which she doesn't need in which I could have lived without. This song wasn't a piece of art, but it's such a good song to listen to and just chill and to have like one of those, you know, the mood when you're like, when you're not super sad, but you're definitely not super happy, or like you're happy, but you're just a little bit sad. Like, that's what it feels like. Like, everything is fine, but there's just this little part of you that knows that it's not fine. Okay, song number three is called Rose Colored Lenses. Ooh, 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 hey, hey, whew, yeah. Sunrise got us up early. Oh. So we put on our shade. Oh, I think this is so much better than the last song. What you doing them? Like sticky sweet lemonade. Sticky. Never wanna leave this room. Daydream deja vu. If I had control over you, we could stay like this forever. Lost in wonderland with our head above the clouds, falling stupid like we're kids, wearing rose colored lenses. Let's just play pretend. Drown me in your delight. That bass is so nice. Oh my god. Endless summer vacation. Ooh. We could stay like this forever. Nothing but good vibes. Oh my god. We could stay like this forever. Lost in wonderland with our head above the clouds, falling stupid like we're kids, wearing rose colored lenses. Let's just play pretend. Let's stay like this forever. Let's stay like this forever. Ooh. Wonderful. That was beautiful. Oh my god, okay, this is my, for now, this is definitely my favorite song from the album, and we're only on track three. I mean, so far, she has been able to perfectly capture the summer feel. Yeah, I will be eating this gladly. Thank you for this delicious meal. Oh my lord, if I would have heard this album when I was like 17 or 18, I would have, like, teenagers are about to have the best summer of their lives if they're going to be listening to this album. Oh my god. Okay, Thousand Miles featuring Brandi Carlile. Oh yeah. Ooh, this is so chill. I'm driving around town in a beat up old Mercedes. You think I'm crazy? No sense, so don't ask me where I've been. I'm not always right, but still I ain't got time for work when I'm gone. This kind of makes me feel of Hannah Montana music. Or like, so Miley Cyrus, but like in the TV, like, oh my god. Just made me feel so many things at once. 1,000 miles from anywhere. Ooh, that progression. Not always right, but still I ain't got time for what went wrong. Where I am. Oh my god. Ooh. Ooh. Hmm. Like, this song could be in the Hannah Montana movie. Okay, so another beautiful song. I really liked it. I know I like the song right now already, but I know that if I was a teenager who was listening to this, oh, yeah, mm-hmm, Oh, so good. Oh my god, I really liked it. You. Ooh. Yes.
I wanna set off alarms, deal out the cards, smoke Cuban cigars, and get kicked out of bars before two.
Oh.
But only if it's with you.
I don't know what these songs are called, but these ballads with these like minor progressions of the melody, I die for those. This is like one of my all-time favorite types of songs. It's like this. And with Miley's voice, are you kidding me? Oh my god! Got chills. Just how excited I am. I mean, I thought it was just gonna be like a sexy song or something, but we're going into this. Oh.
Get kind of reckless and I bought sex under the moon.
Yes.
But only if it's with you.
Oh, yes.
I got some baggage. Let's do some damage. I'm not made for no horse and carriage. I want that late night sweet magic, that forever lasting love. But only if it's with you.
Goosebumps. Oh,
let's
my God.
Crash a wedding tonight. Floor of your own.
Oh, this is so
but
good.
Only if it's with you. I got some baggage. Let's do some damage. I'm not made for no horse and carriage. I don't need Jesus, cause baby, you saved me. I'm done. But only if it's with you.
I don't know if this is the first place or the second place, but the song is definitely another favorite for sure. Oh, so good. Oh my god. I'll never get tired of saying this, but her voice is everything to me. It's magic. Handstand. Wow. Very unexpected. Big twitchy.
Surfed the North Break, cause that's all we knew.
I don't know what's going on right now. Okay, wow, I really didn't expect this song, because before this, I, like, imagined myself driving on an ocean road in summer and just chilling and having, like, a funky little road trip, but this song just kind of, like, you know, crashed into me and I really didn't expect it. I still really liked it. It just shattered my vision of this album, you know what I mean? Whew. The song is very horny and very like, oh, wow. But if I choose to ignore the lyrics and just focus on the music, it kind of makes me feel really, really sad. So I think this is going to my upbeat sad songs playlist. Whew. Okay, River. Are we back on our chill vibes? Sounds like we are. That funky little bass. We're still sticking to this like weird electronic vibe. Okay. It's a choice. I respect it. I kind of love this. I like this. Yeah. So horny. I can't figure out if this song is corny or if it's about something else. Ooh! I mean, it's a pop. Ooh. Ooh. Very interesting. I'm so conflicted right now. I don't know what's going on. I feel like I had everything figured out, but now I feel like I don't know anything. I mean, song's a bop. I think I'm still like very shocked that this isn't just like a simple poppy album that I was hoping it was gonna be. It is a little bit more complex than that, but it's okay. Cause I still like it. Ooh. Okay, we'll see. Violet Chemistry. That sounds like a Lana Del Rey song. Really weird electronic choices made here. And the lights come on, but you don't wanna leave. But I like it. Stay a while with me. I'm so confused. What is reality? What is my life? Such a sweet, like, quick change. Put them around me. Fingers start to dance along the figures and the shapes. Mixing all the colors like we're making a Monet. There's something between us that's too major to ignore. Fingers start to dance along the figures and the shapes. Mixing all the colors like we're making a Monet. Not done or nothing more. Then I would just be wrong. Ain't done this in so long. I'm so confused. Okay. A lot of things are going on in this song. A lot of things. And most of the times, I mean it in a good way. This time, I'm not so sure. I think the parts of the song just don't fit that good with each other. There's just something a tiny bit odd. I can't quite pinpoint what it is. Maybe it's the starting note or something. I don't know. But it's just a little bit weird. I really love the bridge. Electronic, whatever. That's fun. That's fun to listen to. I'm gonna listen to the song a few more times for sure, but first impression is not very good. I mean, we'll see. Muddy Feet featuring Sia.
I don't know who the hell you think you're messing with. Get the fuck out of my house with that shit. Get the fuck out of my life with that shit.
Okay, okay.
And you smell like perfume that I didn't purchase. Now I know why you've been closing the curtains on. Get the fuck out of my house. You got me wrong with your muddy feet.
Yeah.
I'm about to do something about it.
Yeah.
With your muddy feet, and I'm gonna have to do something about it. And I'm about to do something about it. Back and forth, always questioning my question. Get the fuck out of my head with that shit.
Hold on. This is exactly perfect. Everything about this is perfect. Her voice fits just right. Like, this is the type of music that she should be making, in my opinion. It's kind of like a little bit villainous. Not villainous, like female rage music. Yes, I love that so much. The melody progression, I'm surprised. Like, that piano, like, what was that right after the chorus? That scared me. It's so good.
And I'm about to do somebody. Back and forth, always questioning my question.
Oh my god, that's so good. Oh my god. It's just so, ooh. Like, I expected a drop, but then we go into the verse and wow. Okay, going back.
And I'm about to do somebody. Back and forth, always questioning my question. Get the fuck out of my head with that shit. You watered the weeds and you killed all the roses. Worthy arrives when the other door closes. So get the fuck out of my house with that shit. You got me wrong. Ooh. With your muddy feet, I'm about to do somebody. And I don't know who you're messing with. And I'ma have to do somebody.
Oh my god, yes, that was beautiful. Okay, this song 10 out of 10 makes me feel so like, yeah. No comments, just pure perfection. She should be, like, this is the music I want her to make all the time. Perfect. Okay, wild card. Are we back on our...
Do you wanna play house? I could be your wife. Go and meet your mom in a dress too tight. Maybe I could stay and not break your heart.
I definitely like the song, but I don't know if I'm obsessed with it. I don't know if I'm going to be listening to it all the time and be like, yeah. It's okay, I think. Yeah. Her voice carries fucking everything. Just listening to her sing, even if the song is bad, I probably will, just to hear her voice. Oh my god, I have an issue. Okay, next song is Island. Very, very islandy, I'll give her that. Ooh, water. Song, you know what I mean? I feel like verse is one song, pre-chorus is another song, and then the chorus is a completely different song. It's just like, it doesn't feel like it flows together very well. I still like it, I think. Next song is Wonder Woman. Lived a thousand lives. Oh, that's beautiful. Never know. Only when she cries. Oh. When her favorite rag is on and she's dancing in the dark. She can't stop her eyes from welling up. Oh. She makes sure that no one's around to see her fall apart. She wants to be the one that never dies. But when her favorite record's on and she's dancing in the dark, she can't stop her eyes from welling up. Oh, she makes sure that no one's around to see her fall apart. She wants to be the one that never dies. Cry. Beautiful, 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 beautiful ballad. Wow. I don't know how many times I've said this, but yeah, her voice. Just so beautiful. And there's so much emotion in that song as well. I like that. Alrighty, right. So this was Endless Summer Vacation by Miley Cyrus. Very exciting and very weird album. I don't know if I mean it in a good way though. Muddy Feet, definitely one of my favorites. You, Rose Colored Lenses, Wonder Woman, Jaded, and Flowers. Everything else, I would have survived without listening to it. Maybe it's one of those songs where you need to listen to it a few times and then be accustomed to it and then be like, oh, okay, I know what's going on now. But definitely not how I felt. Miley Cyrus is a genius and she's a queen and she can sing whatever she wants and she will always be that girl. I don't care what anybody says. I don't care. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you liked it. Let me know what you think of her new album. What are your thoughts? Do you also feel a little bit awkward in some places or am I crazy? yeah, see you guys next time. Love you. Bye.